It's starting to look as if Spain's future could hinge on a few hundred policemen currently hanging out on a cruise ship in the port of Barcelona. With the rebel government in the eastern region of Catalonia determined to plow forward with its independence campaign in defiance of Spanish authorities, those officers are the most concrete instrument of state power left to Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy. Last time he deployed them, it was a disaster. The Spanish forces were sent in Sunday after the Catalan police ignored orders to shut down an illegal referendum. Subsequent images of officers in riot gear beating walled participants drove moderates into the separatist camp, damaging Rajoy's support in the rest of Europe. And the poll went ahead anyway, albeit without the proper controls of the electoral register to prevent double voting. On Monday, the separatist leadership is preparing to defy the Spanish Constitutional Court again, this time with a parliamentary debate on the next steps to independence. Any repeat of Sunday's violence would make it hard for Rajoy to put his country back together again. Spanish riot police in Barcelona during the referendum. Sign up to receive the Balance of Power newsletter in your inbox and follow Bloomberg Politics on Twitter and Facebook for more. Global headlinesser and deal in doubt. U.S. President Donald Trump is weighing a new strategy to confront Iran's nuclear ambitions that would leave a 2015 agreement intact for now, three administration officials told Nick Wadhams and Stephen T. Dennis. Still, his comments sounded ominous for the future of the accord. The Islamic Republic hasn't lived up the spirit of the nuclear agreement, Trump said. You'll be hearing about Iran very shortly. Theresa May faces mutiny. Former Conservative Party chairman Grant Shapps told Tim Ross the British Prime Minister should step aside so the party can elect a new leader, and a number of colleagues back his view. Senior Tory figures said they didn't think the party rebels have the numbers yet to oust her. The turmoil pushed the pound lower as Brexit negotiators wonder who'll be sitting across the table in coming months. U.S. gun lobby backs small change. The National Rifle Association followed top Republicans in conceding the tiniest of ground in the gun control debate. The powerful lobbying group said a device used by the Las Vegas shooter to modify semi-automatic weapons should be subject to additional regulations. At the same time, the NRA reiterated its opposition to stricter gun controls and called for legislation requiring states to recognize all retakery permits. Classified NSA documents. Stolen. Russian hackers obtained classified information about National Security Agency cyber programs after breaching a personal computer used by an agency contractor in 2015. The unidentified contractor took the classified material home, where Russian hackers stole it, by exploiting vulnerabilities in Kaspersky Lab Incorporated software on his computer. It's the latest breach to come to light involving an NSA contractor and could factor into the overall probe of Moscow's efforts to influence the 2016 election. Australia's lost decade. 26 years of unbroken economic growth, abundant resources and an enviable lifestyle have made Australia look like a miracle economy to much of the world. Look a little closer, and the picture is less rosy. In a series of stories this week, Bloomberg explores how a decade of political dysfunction is hindering the nation's prospects, with successive governments failing to address soaring property prices, crippling electricity bills, a stagnant stock market and slower internet speeds than Kenya. And finally, Trump's penchant for cryptic threats was on display last night at the White House, where he described a gathering with military leaders as the calm before the storm. When reporters pressed him to clarify, the president replied, "You'll find out." While he's used aggressive rhetoric against several countries recently, including Iran and Venezuela, his toughest criticism has been aimed at North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, whom he calls Little Rocket Man. No matter what Trump meant, the comments will add to concerns among Asian leaders when he visits the region next month. Trump was senior military leaders yesterday.